Hello, I'm Tim Kokotovich. I am the elementary math coach here at KIS. The three-act task is a mathematical activity that's in its beginning stages here at KIS. It is a whole group mathematical activity with an engaging and perplexing act one, an information-seeking and solution-seeking act two, and then a discussion and a solution revealing act three. It really does a good job of encouraging students to become question askers instead of just question answers, and to communicate and to work together and to share out different ways of seeing how to solve a problem. Act one is when we show a video, generally a video, or we show a situation that is perplexing. When you watch it, it begs you to have questions. During act one, we show them the video or we do the thing and we ask students to come up with the questions that their brains think of as they watch this.
What does making a paperclip have to do with math?
Interesting. What does making a paperclip flat have to do with math right here? Thank you very much.
Why, do they have to straighten
and open the larger one? I'm with you. Thank you for that.
Is this like about fractions, like related to fractions?
Also in Act 1 is the prediction stage. The prediction stage is when we go back and re-watch the video or re-watch the situation and we ask students, what are your predictions? What is your best guess as to what the answer should be? This is good because when we calculate and get a final answer, we want to know if it's reasonable. And we can check to see if it's reasonable by going back to our original predictions. Okay, my people. If this is one unit, how long will that one be once we stretch it out? I'm taking predictions, best guesses right now. Here we go. I want to start from the left and go to the right, right here, please.
At least two, because the full one stretched out is one. I think the biggest number could be five, but I think probably four.
The last bit of Act 1 is to ask students, okay, you have a question. You have a prediction as to what the answer might be. What information might you want to know? And I love this question because generally in mathematical word problems, you're just given information. In a three-act task, you're given the question and you're asked, what information would you like to know in order to solve that? And that involves a whole deeper level of thought, which is amazing to see. What type of information would you like to know in order to find out how long this guy will be when we stretch it out?
Oh, how long is paperclip?
Yeah, how long is this? Is the small one or the big one here? Okay, so you would like to know how long the paperclip is, so the small one and the big one. You'd like to know how long these are. Act two is when the work happens. We generally put them out into pairs or triads or groups, and we show them the information that we have, and we ask them to solve the problem with the people around them. Generally, it is a time for students to put together all their thinking and get to a final answer. Act three is all about revealing the finale, to get that, to watch a video that reveals the answer and to give students that quick feedback as to if they got the right answer or not. It's also really important in Act three to have a conversation about the different ways that different groups got to our answer. We know that our brain becomes stronger mathematically when we can see different ways of attacking a problem, and that's what Act three is all about.
For the 31.5 centimeters, we got there by we first multiplication, but then we made a number line and we made it by tens and twenties and thirties, and then we skipped, and then it became to 30, and then we did 31.5. We showed that and then did this.
We think that it's important to do three-act tasks because there's been a movement lately to help our students become less of a calculator and more of a critical thinker. And three-act tasks do a great job of helping students see math in the everyday and helping students be the person to ask the question and then find the information and then solve for a question.